know, I always wanted to be able to lead Chicago Bulls from the bottom to the top.
The Chicago Bulls have won their first ever NBA championship.
The motivation was to show people that the first time wasn't a fluke, that we were going to be on top for a long period of time, and this is a way to put a stamp on that, and to do it twice gives us some legitimacy as a franchise.
And let the celebration begin here in the Windy City.
The Bulls have repeated.
A couple teams, the Lakers and Detroit, both were in situations where they could have won three in a row. This is our opportunity to show that we can do something that Magic Johnson and Detroit Pistons never did.
For the third year, Michael Jordan and the Chicago Bulls have climbed the Mount Olympus of the NBA.
To get back on top and to do it in a fashion that you alleviate all the questions that people had about your skills and your leadership qualities, and to, you know, more or less just say, hey, we're back.
After a two-year absence, the Chicago Bulls have regained the NBA throne.
It's getting tougher just from facing all the different challenges of staying on top. It's like the king of the hill. I mean, everybody's going to be coming at you and trying to knock you off. But each time you win, it's more gratifying, you know, that you withstood all the challenges, and yet here you are again, right back on top. So we look forward to doing that again.
Fresh off last year's championship and an NBA record 72 wins, the Chicago Bulls seem to have little left to prove as they enter the 1996-97 season.
We tried to take some pressure off our team, so we started out very, very slow this year. Single practices in training camp, some days off, and we said, don't worry about getting off to a great start. And we got off to the best start we've ever had as a franchise.
Harper to Jordan. Leaps.
Busler and Jordan take it away. Jordan. He did give it to him ultimately.
Chicago beginning to kick on all cylinders now.
Scotty in the middle. Oh, yeah. Scotty hard to the basket.
That is red hot.
MJ's on that side.
Whoa, yes, sir.
Fakes. Oh, what a great play by Scotty. Oh, great look.
The fans in this building loving it.
Michael in backcourt with four, with three, with one. The shot is good, but now he
got it. That's good,
baby. Michael got it. It's going to be that kind of afternoon for MJ.
The Bulls open the season an amazing 17-1. And as always, the main catalysts were Michael Jordan and Scottie Pippen.
Everything has been special because we've tried to take it to a higher level to become the greatest duo to ever play the game.
Michael was capable of incorporating Scotty's abilities and, you know, telling him sometimes you got to help me out and some nights I'm not going to have it. I'll help you out if you don't have it, and we'll tag team this thing together.
These guys have played together so long, they know every move that they're going to make.
When I walked away from the game for 2 years, Scotty was exposed to what I had to deal with. So when I came back, there was a certain understanding, and we grew close. And you can see that within the way that we play.
And with their two leaders more in sync than ever, the Bulls continued their blazing start. They had a league-best record of 42-6 entering All-Star Weekend, where Jordan and Pippen were honored as two of the league's 50 greatest players.
Let us salute together the greatest NBA players of all time.
And fittingly, they would share an historic moment.
Here's Jordan with an opportunity. As Pippen, and there it is, triple-double for Michael Jordan. The first ever in the history of the NBA All-Star Game.
But it wasn't only Chicago's superstars who had a chance to shine.
Steve Kerr is on fire.
He is on
fire.
He
may not miss.
This is the biggest, the money ball.
Oh, yes!
And this year's All-Star Weekend three-point shooting champion, Steve Kerr.
Kerr highlighted the importance of the Bulls' role players, who each make their own contribution to the team's success.
I think a lot of it is Phil's philosophy of using the bench, using
all 12 guys, having everybody feel like a big part of it. And as a result, you know, kind of making the team more than just the sum of its parts.
Oh, yeah.
There are so many outstanding role players on this Chicago Bull team.
When players have something to offer a team, a coach has to recognize their individual talents and what they can give to a basketball club. So I like to make everybody feel like they have a role that they can play on this team.
Beautifully done. Unselfish teamwork.
When you feel wanted and you feel needed, it inspires you to play better, thus making you more wanted and more needed.
With their unique blend of talent and teamwork, the Bulls were stampeding their way through the season and having fun doing it.
Sensational! Inside Dennis, great pass for Luke, who slams it. Kerr goes down low for Luke. Bounce pass, great pass to Randy Brown.
Rodman looking long. Throws it to Tony. It's online!
Hello, Tony!
Randy Brown started to slow it down, brings it inside.
Oh, yeah. Pass inside! Jason putting on a show for the fans here.
Kerr to run.
Oh, there it is.
Back door to Pip on the reverse.
Yes! And he did not have the handle, but somehow made it go. 44 for Pippen, career high.
Rodman.
Full extension trying to haul that in.
Chief, look.
Brother.
Give it back. Hammer down for the Chief. How about that?
Let it fly. Let it fly.
Jason with a steal, picks it up. See if he can go all the way. Caffey goes down, off the
glass.
Got it, counted, and he's fouled. What a ball game for Jason Caffey.
Pippen to Jordan, time winding down for the win.
Yeah! You can't believe it! He does it again! Michael Jordan, a game winner, hit the buzzer!
But as the season entered its final weeks, the joy that had seemed to envelop the Bulls would now begin to evaporate. They encountered the first major roadblocks in their drive to repeat as champions, losing several of their key players to injuries.
We had everything, I guess, working against us because we had a lot of injuries and guys out of the lineup here and there, and it was tough.
To help fill the void, they signed free agent Brian Williams, who had not played all season.
Williams, he'll go up inside Biskin at point blank range.
Gotta finish that play.
The team that had been a juggernaut had suddenly begun to falter.
We had a bunch of guys out on the floor that hadn't played together, and the chemistry and the feeling that we've had on the court wasn't there, and we struggled.
With five left, Jordan for the tie, didn't happen. Cavaliers got it done. 73-70, fewest points by a Chicago basketball club since 1995.
It's Jordan against Starks. Jordan on the drive, gives it up. Pippen for three. Have defeated the Bulls. The Bulls do not make it back-to-back 70-win seasons.
What had begun with all the makings of another record-setting season had ended in doubt, and the timing could not have been worse.
Suddenly, you know, our season was tilted and ajar, and we never really had an intact group the very last month. You know, it was going to be a push to just get going in the playoffs.
Everyone, and welcome to Bulls basketball at the United Center as we get the playoffs underway in round one, game one.
Determined to put their late season slump behind them, the Bulls open the playoffs against a young and hungry Washington Bullet team, out to make a bold statement against the defending champions.
Howard kept it alive. Bullets controlling the offensive board. His weapon.
But in game one, Washington's hopes of an upset would be snuffed out by the Bulls' suffocating defense.
By Scotty. Oh, he had lunch with the Metric.
Strickland. Murray comes over the back, but hangs on.
up the floor, scouting from, near the basket.
5 minutes, Howard pops it out. Murray, blocked by Pippen.
That, you know, our defense was the key tonight, and that's what you need in the playoffs. And we had to put on our defense to kind of pull this one off.
Undaunted, the confident Bullets stayed close again in game two, but they had no answer for the Bulls' leader, who was simply unstoppable.
It's going to be that kind of afternoon for MJ.
He's putting on a show here. I'm telling you, this has been some kind of offensive performance by Michael Jordan.
He's adding to the legend today.
Jordan would burn the Bullets for 55 points and carry the Bulls to victory in spectacular style.
That is one of the extraordinary playoff performances in the history of the NBA.
I got into that zone, if you want to call it, and I couldn't get out. You know, and I apologized to Tex after the game. I didn't. Sorry about the triangle, Tex. I kind of forgot about the triangle. And, you know, I mean, once I got in that mood, I just couldn't turn it off.
But back home in Washington, the Bullets would not go quietly and had the champs on the ropes late in game three.
Spectacular play by Tracy Murray.
Sometimes we're down 17 or 18. You feel the same. Hey, we got these guys right where we want them. Don't worry about anything. We come back and win those games. The guys on our team just know how to win.
Charging back from a 9-point deficit in the final 5 minutes, the Bulls still found themselves in need of some last-second heroics.
95-94, Bullets by one. Michael off the dribble, darts to the lane, went in the air, lost it. Scotty got it back. Pippen a drive, good!
Yes, he got it!
And the Bulls win it, and the Bullets go home. The Bulls go on, they sweep the Bullets on a drive and a dunk by Scotty Pippen.
Lying in wait in the second round were the Atlanta Hawks, a team eager to shatter the Bulls' championship mystique. And as the series began, Chicago's doubts resurfaced as they once again seemed vulnerable.
So the Atlanta Hawks playing energized basketball and causing problems for Phil Jackson.
Bulls really look out of sorts right now.
The aggressive Hawks quickly proved they were not in awe of the Bulls' dynasty.
Hip dunk is a beauty by Mutombo.
Now the Bulls just look dispirited now. They look like their hearts aren't even in this.
Handing Chicago its first home playoff loss in 14 games, Atlanta would steal the home court advantage.
The Atlanta Hawks stun the Chicago Bulls here in game two.
We're just kind of down for his energy-wise. We're not executing, but unless we do the things that we've done all season to get 69 wins, and we're not going to pull another win out of this series.
And in Atlanta, the Hawks gained even more confidence, taking an early lead in game three.
All the Atlanta fans were going crazy. We were down 10 midway through the second quarter, and we were a little unsure of ourselves. We just didn't quite have it.
Smith, wide open left side. The three's good!
Atlanta, they are jacked up as they have dominated this game.
Great concern on the part of the Chicago Bulls.
Well, we just weren't playing Bulls basketball, and it was tough. But Michael and Scottie stepped up and showed great leadership, and we started to get things rolling a little bit.
As they had done so many times before, Jordan and Pippen would bring the Bulls back.
Long lead for Michael. MJ catches, back to Pippen, running in, layup.
Yes! The Bulls, they're now turning it up a little bit.
The Bulls have suddenly shown some life.
The first game of Atlanta, I think we really needed Scotty and Michael, the leaders of the team, always there, and they pushing us.
And the rest of the team would follow their lead.
Tony, three, Tony fires, score!
Wow!
Two coach, wow! Lead pass Pippen. Scotty for Brian Williams, and he dunks it.
The Bulls had now broken the game open, and it was left to Jordan to provide the finishing touch.
Left-handed wraparound. Good for Michael Jordan.
The Hawks appearing to have run out of gas.
The Bulls would see this game as a turning point.
We seemed to have a breakthrough, and we went on to a 20-point victory. I think we sort of broke through some barriers there and started to play much better after that game.
The rejuvenated Bulls would now finish off Atlanta.
Three, are you
That's it.
The energy, everything has been picked up by the Bulls.
Rodman for three.
The Bulls on fire again.
They're just picking Bucks apart now.
The world champions playing like they want to repeat.
Outstanding
pass. What a pass by Dennis.
Wow.
That could be the nail in the coffin.
Emphatically closing out the series, Jordan would send one final message to the upstart Hawks.
Oh, Harry did it! Harry Michael shakes the finger!
He said, I never dunked on him, and I said, well, I'm gonna eventually get you before I leave the game. And tonight was a great time for it.
Hi again, everybody, and welcome once again to Bulls basketball. The Bulls and the Miami Heat about set to square off here at the United Center.
The crowd is excited. This ought to be a fun series.
Throughout the year, one team we never wanted to lose to was Miami.
Over the season, have really developed a real strong rivalry with them. Their physical play really brings out the best in us.
And the Bulls would counter Miami's muscle with their own overpowering display of defense.
Ryan Williams at three. Warriors out. Rebound Morning knocked out. No good. Morning again short.
Hope was big on that defensive play.
I don't think that people really realize how well the Chicago Bulls can defend. Miami was a big test for us, but our guys, showed that they could step up and play, the tremendous D.
Steve Kerr took it away. Backs it in. Back inside. Dennis with a block.
We know at one stage during the basketball game that we're going to just hold you down.
Smothering the Heat, Chicago captured the first two games and rode their wave of momentum right into Miami, where their opportunistic defense would get them off and running, and they never looked back.
Now Jordan with the move on Hardaway.
Blowing out the Heat in their own building, Chicago had taken a firm grip on the series and learned some valuable lessons as well.
Gonna come up over the top of him. The shot's good.
We figured out how to not go macho for macho against him, but, play within yourself. Play your game, meet their intensity, but don't let them take you out of what you're trying to do on the court.
Having been embarrassed by the Bulls, Miami was in desperate need of a rallying cry for Game 4, and they would get it from their leader, Alonzo Mourning.
We will win on Monday. We're going to win on Monday.
The Heat would take command right from the start, with Mourning eager to deliver on his bold guarantee.
That's what the Miami Heat have been looking for.
Alonzo's open left side, slams it in.
This is just what the Chicago Bulls wanted to stop in this whole series.
We felt they tried to take our manhood. They beat us up. They pounded on us.
Heat aren't going away without a fight.
Alonzo Mourning was doing a lot of talking the entire series. And when he elbowed Scotty and Scotty got that bump on his head, I think Michael kind of took it personally.
And I think that set Michael off. So when he came back into practice after that weekend on Tuesday, he said, guys, this one's a personal test. When we come out there today, I want this game to be a grudge match.
It's personal, but enough has been said. You got to go out and play with a lot of intensity, a lot of heart.
Let's go.
And from the beginning, Jordan would serve notice to the Heat that he was on a personal mission.
Yeah, score it for Michael Jordan. Jordan with a dribble. Pull up for Sean Leonard. Yes! Michael Jordan is on fire.
And even though Scottie Pippen would be forced out of the game early with an injured foot, the rest of the Bulls would help Michael finish his mission.
Bushler is there. The Chicago bench. Double job.
Happy.
Strong.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, oh.
Took it to the hoop and threw down a slammer.
Their collective will had lifted them once more.
Look at Tony. He is pumped up.
And with their emotional triumph, the Bulls would convincingly wrap up the series and steamroll their way to the finals.
Crowd is on its feet. The Bulls are going to the finals.
Yes, sir.
It's good to be the conference champion, but, to come up short doesn't really mean nothing. We want to get all the way to the ring and, make it five, go on from there.
Awaiting the Bulls in the finals were MVP Karl Malone, John Stockton, and the Utah Jazz, who had finally become Western Conference champions.
John Stockton! John Stockton!
not good. It's over. We're on our way to the World Championship.
We fought a long time to get here. We didn't just come here just to show up. We came here to play, and as long as we as a team believe in ourselves and believe that we can beat these guys, we can.
Hi again, everybody, and welcome to Chicago for the NBA World Championship Game 1. It should be a dandy.
Yeah, we're taking it. We're
going to win it tonight.
Trying to win one for the Thumb, the fifth time in 7 years, and now they go against the amazing Utah Jazz with John Stockton and Karl Malone.
Slam program, Game 1 program.
You couldn't have asked for a better matchup, especially with Sloan's ties to Chicago.
How you doing?
Hard to go against Michael Jordan and home court advantage, but with a subpar Scottie Pippen, I think Utah has an excellent chance to grab one of these first two games.
Control Stockton, that means everybody get your eye on him. Make sure you see him where he's at on the court. They'll get the ball to him right away.
This is what you work hard for.
What time is it?
Game time!
Since the dawn of spring, the Utah Jazz have been the best basketball team in the NBA. They're ready, and there's no excuses from Utah.
Congratulations.
This series features the NBA's most valuable player and the guy who many feel should have won this year's MVP award.
Relax. I'm not going to fool you. Relax.
And from the beginning, the Jazz were determined to make it clear that they belonged on the NBA's biggest stage.
That's exactly the type of ball that Utah has to play.
Carmelo, got it by Rodman, a follow-away 15-footer by the mailman, good!
As Utah grabbed an early lead, the Bulls struggled to chip away the rust of a five-day layoff.
The Bulls are off to a very shaky start.
Against Phil Jackson, a little upset that the team didn't come out with more intensity.
Hey, let's get ourselves together on this. Light them up.
And in typical Chicago fashion, it was the Bulls' defense that provided them with a spark.
Pushed with the steal. And the rebound handled by Carr. Traveling violation. What a play by Hoffer.
Same thing you get, Johnson. You didn't call it, though. But I don't want to hear that. Same thing you get.
The Jazz clung to a slim lead as Game 1 evolved into a classic battle, with the superstars from each team rising to the challenge.
Here's Jordan.
Gonna pull it up, fadeaway 14-footer's good, Michael.
Come on! Fight for the ball!
And Harper battles through it a second time. Now Malone rolls past it.
Yeah! Yeah, ball! Way to go, go!
The Bulls, however, would get an unexpected lift from a determined Scottie Pippen.
Pippen is showing some signs despite the foot injury.
Flashes to the top. Taken away by Pippen, who blocked Russell. An easy layout. The place will explode. Scottie Pippen has really sorry now.
Jordan putting moves on Isley and pops it out. Pippen for three. Yes!
Pippen with the three-point bomb.
What an incredible basketball game.
This is it, my man. This is what you work hard for. Have fun.
In the closing minutes, with the outcome hanging in the balance, the stage was set for a dramatic finish. And each team's leading men would again step forward.
They've got it right there. Back to the basket. The double
down low left into Jordan. Jordan backs in. One horn a set. Michael left to right. Far away. 15 footer.
Good. Chicago leads.
John needs to play with poise here. Goes right side. Back to the mailman. Faking. Driving. Force it up and in. Great move on the underhand scoop. The Jazz lead 79-78.
Rebounded by Hoffer.
Back to Pippen for three. Oh.
Pippen's three. Leads it. Good. Pippen with a three. It's 81-79. It can't get any better than this.
Stockton circles. Looking.
Stockton wide right. Stockton down low to Antron. Back to Stock. Three-pointer. He got it. He got it. John Stockton.
The Jazz by one. 82-81.
It's going to be whoever has the ball last.
Chicago's got to be concerned, folks.
Stockton off the dribble. Stockton, top of the key. Stockton, Jacks one and missed it. Long rebound, Malone.
Malone's got it. 9 seconds. There's a loose ball foul. It's on Rodman.
That puts Karl Malone on the line with the game tied at 82.
Malone now with the first free throw. Takes his time. The crowd frantic behind the glass. No, he missed it. It rimmed out.
Now the
Bulls with an opportunity.
One more for Karl Malone. 9 seconds left in this game.
Just make sure you follow through and don't short arm him.
He misses. You've got to get this rebound, Malone.
Oh, he missed the ball. Rebounded by Cork. And the Bulls have the timeout.
Bulls get a last chance. 7 5/10 left.
What do you think Phil Jackson is thinking about? Will it automatically be Michael Jordan?
I think it'll go to Michael Jordan and then let him create.
Bulls basketball and a chance to win it right here.
Two coaches got the ball inbounds from Pippen, and here is Michael. Four on the shot clock now. Keeps it on the dribble. Russell's there.
MJ, top of the circle against Russell. Michael hangs, fires, scores!
If somebody asked you to name your three favorite, or the three you remember best.
1982 is easy. Cleveland is certainly easy. That's the only two I can remember. I'm getting senile, I guess. I've had so many, I can't even remember them all.
It's been 72 hours since Michael Jordan performed the latest in a career filled with heroics, and players and fans have waited anxiously for this game two of the best of seven.
After their heartbreaking loss in game one, the Jazz looked to bounce back. But on this night, they'd face a Chicago team that was hitting on all cylinders.
Chicago coming down, up a couple of field goals, and greedy for more. Longley's gonna lay it in. Slam dunk! Chicago playing like the champions.
Michael the assist. Turn up the energy.
What a beginning.
It's all falling apart for the Jazz right now.
1 second timeout.
They're just going to have to totally regroup.
Reeling from Chicago's onslaught, the Jazz try to fight their way back.
Stockton looking in to Karl Malone. Crowd's got a twist right. Look at score.
Utah battling away.
Hornacek fires one up. And hits.
Yeah, boy. Yeah!
And who knows what's going to happen here.
But the Bulls had all the answers. And they would find a way to stop the Utah surge.
Screen across, slipping Hornacek back. Playing Hornacek, Stockton, and Malone in a triangle.
Any hopes of a Jazz rally quickly faded as their finely tuned offense was completely shut down.
Up top to Malone. Carl dumped inside. Russell's all alone. Blocked by Pippen. It is Chicago's defense which is authoring the story here in game two.
Malone rejected. Recovered by Anderson.
Help! Help shot! Help shot! 24-second violation.
The defense has been suffocating. The Jazz can't get anything on.
When you've got incredibly agile, active, long-armed defenders, you can really commit to the ball. And we had guys just jumping the ball handler, Stockton or Malone or whoever it was that had the ball, and making it hard for them to get anywhere with their offense, and it stifled them.
Well, this is Chicago Bull basketball. It's all clicking now.
With the Bulls at their best, the route was on.
The way picked back up by Stockton. Michael is still. MJ runs it by Russell. Michael to the top of the key, whipped to Pippen. He goes up, dunks the ball.
Great pass from MJ.
12 unanswered by Chicago.
Finishing one assist shy of a triple-double, Jordan would again turn the finals into his own personal showcase.
Back to Michael, circles, runs inside, reverses, scores! What a move by MJ!
Yes, sir!
But the Jazz still had to endure one final dagger.
Knocked away, Dennis got it back. Wheels, fires a three, got it!
Oh, man! Icing on the cake!
Chicago up 2-0. Let's go to Salt Lake.
We just got waxed tonight as a whole. And now we go home. And now you go home and try to protect your home court.
You are witnessing history in Salt Lake City. It has never happened before. The Utah Jazz, a home team in the NBA Finals. The scene outside the Delta Center, frankly, a party.
Chicago doesn't know what windy is until the Jazz blow them away.
Show me the title!
I expect that crowd to be extremely loud, a little bit rowdy, and ready to roll.
That'll be 20,000 of them
You want to be able to hear yourself talk here. I mean, they absolutely go bananas.
Not in the house! Sit down!
The Bulls would love to take the 3-0, and the Jazz are in a desperate situation where they need a win for sure.
Get after this team early. Get your spots early in your triangle so you can operate, get yourself settled in. Play hard every play.
But the Bulls were taken right out of their game plan by a Jazz team that was suddenly re-energized. Setting a new tone with their aggressive play, Utah came storming back into the series.
So Utah has come out more aggressive.
Stock front court left. Stock down the middle to Melvin. Drive, hang, score. Pellet, and he's fouled.
Fast break basketball for the Utah Jazz.
Carl, free throw line, jump it up. Here we go, Utah champion, the Greg Foster.
The Bulls seem frustrated tonight.
Foster for three. Yes! Mark Foster has been a major factor.
The Jazz with their biggest lead of the game.
Now the Bulls beginning to unravel a little bit.
We're not on the boards. We're not getting seconds. GT defense is absolutely horrible.
And things would only get worse for the Bulls as Karl Malone would deliver one of his greatest performances.
Up top, Karl Malone, fake left, go right, power to the hoop, scoop it, score it! The Melvin!
Malone simply took over the game, scoring 37 points.
Karl Malone with a big-time game.
MVP! MVP!
A chant of MVP for Karl Malone.
You gotta love it, baby!
You would hardly believe that this is the same team which dominated Game 2.
It's either the altitude or they did not take the Jazz seriously.
Phil, did the altitude or anything else bother Michael tonight?
There is a certain factor about that. Usually the first run, these guys kind of acclimate themselves to it. But they're the ones that experience it. I was a little bit short of breath on the sideline, but not too bad.
Get the ball down there and shaped up early enough, you can keep driving this team crazy because they'll be all over the ballpark. They're just going to run around and play defense all over the place. You just keep your space and keep filling in behind.
The Bulls had lost some of their momentum, but not their composure. Getting ready for Game 4, they calmly prepared to execute their strategy.
Go, Luke, go, Luke, go, Dennis.
But as the game began, Chicago's carefully crafted plan was derailed by Utah's furious attack.
Well, nothing is going smoothly at the offensive end for Chicago. Everything is a struggle, and you have to give a lot of that credit to the Jazz defense.
The block by Ostertag, but Hopper able to hang in.
Utah starting to find the rhythm.
Bounce to Malone. Bangs into Rodman, goes up and scores.
No call.
Utah's got ahead of steam.
Horty, off-balance shot, blocked by Pippen, picked up by Karl Malone, to Russell for three, for the angle right, yes! Jazz up 48-44!
Though the Jazz continued their assault,
down the middle, to Foster, slammed up! Greg Foster!
The Bulls stuck to their game plan.
Rob the defense, move it on to the next guy.
Chicago battled to stay within range, and as Game 4 entered the final stretch, they began one of their trademark runs.
Long, oh, a facial surgery.
Chicago finally getting some good ball movement.
Michael down the lane, he took the ball.
All the way to the hole.
Back to Carmelo on the angle left, follow away, 16-footer, no good.
The Bulls doing a terrific job defensively, taking the Jazz out of its game. Rebounded by Pippen, and here comes Jordan.
The Bulls had taken control of the game and seemed on the verge of putting the Jazz away.
I mean, we're up five, and we wanted to put a nail in the coffin. Didn't work out that way.
Once again, the resilient Jazz disrupted the Bulls' plans.
Yes! John Stockton makes it 71-69.
Jordan puts the move on Russell.
Staging an emotional comeback, Utah would stun the usually unflappable champs.
Call on Michael Jordan.
That is a tough call against Jordan here.
Jordan, right side. Michael, up top, 20-footer. No good. Rebound, Stockton. Ahead to Carmelo. He's got it. Stockton to the ball. He scores. Jazz take the lead. Incredible.
Jordan outside with Russell there. Fires the three. No. Rattles out. Utah's going to win this, baby. This baby's over. Utah has won game four. And this series is deadlocked at two victories apiece.
I mean, we came here to try to get one game, and that's still there ahead of us. So it's definitely the pivotal game of this series, and we feel like we still have an opportunity to go up.
But the Bulls' confidence would soon give way to concern as they received a stunning blow in the hours leading up to Game 5.
Now, the big story here tonight concerning Michael Jordan's physical conditions. He is suffering from flu-like symptoms. His status is uncertain.
This is Karl Malone's night. He has to show the world just how great a player he is. Marv, the Jazz, they have to win tonight if their dream is going to come true.
The bad news for the Bulls, the stomach virus that has hit Michael Jordan, and you wonder just how much, how long, and how hard he'll be able to go.
Never in the history of the NBA since they've gone to the 2-3-2 format has the home team won all three of the games. The Utah Jazz are favored to do exactly that.
I don't know if Michael can carry the Bulls on the road against the Jazz. This is the finals, and this team is for real, and he needs help. And unless he gets it, I don't believe they're going to win Game 5.
With Jordan stricken by illness, the Bulls would find themselves walking into a lion's den as they face the surging Jazz, the league's MVP, and one of the NBA's most frenzied crowds.
Stockton looking, whipped inside. Malone goes up, counts, and a foul.
And early on, Chicago's worst fears would be realized as Utah would explode out of the gate.
Everything clicking right now for Utah.
Penetrating move, bad pass, knocked away, but Malone runs it down with a good hustle. Anderson, baseline, a slam. This is an embarrassment for Chicago.
The rebound, Steve Kerr. Kerr ahead to Tony, and he threw it away. Kukoc never saw
wasn't
it coming.
Looking.
This is going to be a blowout.
And things would go from bad to worse for Chicago as the Jazz stormed to a 16-point lead in the second quarter.
But if you let this get any more out of reach now, that you're at a point where, especially with Michael ailing, you're in danger of putting yourself in a position where you have no chance to win the game. Jump to Michael, MJ. Against Russell to the free throw line. Hangs in the air, jumper good.
Oh, shot.
Nothing but net for Michael.
Despite his weakened condition, Jordan valiantly kept his Bulls in contention.
And Jordan with 12 of his 16 points here in the second quarter. And the steal by Jordan. Coming behind the back on Russell, he turned it around and fed it to Pippen. And told by Jordan.
But with their leader exhausted, the question remained whether the Bulls could stay within range. And before halftime, the Jazz would provide an ominous answer.
Russell's open on Buchler. Slam! Whoa. A big-time slam! Utah will take a lead in intermission. We talked about that uphill fight, especially in front of a crowd like this and a team as good as Utah. Sometimes you carry the fight to them, but you just don't have enough energy.
Michael still doesn't feel very well. The Bulls need other guys to step in and step up.
Utah just playing unflustered basketball. No matter what you do to them, they run right back at you.
Throughout the second half, the fatigued Jordan would somehow keep the Bulls in the game.
MJ, Michael for three. Come on.
Yes, sir.
MJ and Trey and...
Game 5 had now developed into a tense back-and-forth battle.
Giannis got Jordan in the air. Here's the shot. Good. This is going to be real tough down the stretch. This fourth quarter is going to be a war.
Michael, a drive through traffic. Scoops a shot up and scores.
Tough shot. Jordan is absolutely exhausted and worn out.
And Michael is dead on his feet.
Exhausted.
This is where Utah's been great, with the game close.
Shot clock at four. Marsh. On their feet here at the Delta Center.
Here is Jordan outside. Chicago down three. Puts it down. Drives the lane. A running eight-footer. Yes. And it's a one-point Utah lead.
Michael Jordan, incredible.
As this pivotal contest reached its waning moments, the Jazz would once again look to seize control of the series.
It goes loose ball, picked up by Hornacek, no whistle, shot clock two, Stockton, three, for the lead, another huge three by Stockton.
Same exact spot that he hit, that enormous three-pointer in game four.
Sweat just pouring off Michael Jordan. No time to rest now.
MJ, this will be the guttiest performance maybe all time.
And all eyes here are going to be on Michael Jordan.
On top, Pippen wants it. Wants to go on Hornacek. Demanded the ball. Back Michael. Open three. Yes! Oh. They lead it. 38 points for the Kings.
Stuck a dagger at him with a three.
Yes!
Jordan's crushing three-pointer would finish off the Jazz in game five and cap off one of the most unforgettable performances in NBA history.
Classic performance by the flu-ridden Michael Jordan.
That he gave us today was unbelievable, you know, as his teammates. We really appreciate the way that he steps up and shows his leadership for our ball club.
I didn't want to give up. You know, no matter how sick I was, or how tired I was, or how, you know, low on energy I was, I felt an obligation, you know, to my team, to the city of Chicago, to go out and give that extra effort.
Tonight, the curtain drops as the greatest show on earth performs for the last time. The drive for five will end right where it started, as the Bulls will be crowned Kings of the Hill once again.
You got enough to end it tonight?
I do. I hope everybody else does, too.
They want to get this done tonight. They don't want to have to go to a game seven where almost anything can happen.
First of all, I think you all know we're anxious about this game. This game in which we're all a little nervous about going out and performing well and doing the right thing.
We don't plan on just going out. Not quietly, not easily. So you can guarantee it's going to be a war tonight.
Don't think about anything but the play ahead. The next play, the play you're in, keep your mind and focus.
If the Bulls could win the title tonight, Chicago would become the third franchise to win five titles in a decade. The greatest athlete of our time hopes tonight is a coronation of the greatest dynasty the NBA has seen in three decades.
But the Jazz were determined to write their own chapter in history and not allow a coronation at their expense.
Malone from Stockton. Chicago starting slowly, and Utah is taking advantage of that.
Here they come. Utah in a hurry. The Bulls kind of stood around.
Hornacek. Well, yes.
Look out, Chicago. It's not going to be easy wrapping it up tonight.
The Bulls have not answered the challenge.
Beautiful ball movement, and Karl Malone shoots a layup.
But Jordan refused to let the frustrated Bulls lose their poise. Midway through the second quarter, with Chicago trailing by 10, he would begin to lead them back.
Now Jordan trying to go to work on Russell, and he does.
Bulls seem to have a little more energy right now, starting to find a little bit of rhythm on the defensive end.
Foster firing and missed it badly, and the rebound, Brian Williams. Whipped ahead to Pippen, he'll dunk the ball.
Great look up the court by Brian Williams.
United Center is rocking, the Bulls making a run.
Back to Michael, MJ, hangs, fires, scores!
Yeah, bring it! Tough shot.
The Jazz, however, were answering every Chicago run with one of their own.
Utah tenacious, not giving up that lead.
Stockton with the beautiful ball to beat.
Biggest lead of game six, it's a 10-point advantage for the Utah Jazz.
In the waning moments of the third quarter, Utah still refused to relinquish its lead. And with the game slipping away, there was little doubt what was going through the minds of the Bulls and their leader.
From day one, you want to end up playing in June.
and winning a championship. And it's a lot of bumps in the road.
So we understand what it takes to get to this level. By no means do we want to give this up to win championships. This is a dream. Now, the dream is to sustain this as long as you're still playing the game of basketball.
And with Jordan setting the tone, the Bulls would show the resolve of champions.
The rebound back tapped out of there, and Bushler has it. Judd for three.
Bushler has to fire it.
What a great shot by Judd Bushler.
Scotty on the run. Pippen against Malone. Scotty for three. Come on. Yes. Pippen a three.
UConn needs a timeout. The Bulls are within two.
The crowd back into the game on their feet throughout.
And to Bushler. Corner. Kerr for three. Come
yes.
On.
Chicago needs it on Stevie Kerr's three.
The Chicago Bulls have taken the lead for the first time with 10 unanswered points.
But Utah would not fold. And just as they had done throughout the finals, the Jazz would once again push Chicago to the limit.
Sex saves it, Anderson. Here comes three from Russell. Oh, yes!
An enormous shot by Brian Russell. He's tied the game at 86.
The Bulls have it with 28 seconds left.
In the final seconds, with the score tied and the game on the line, this classic series would hinge on one dramatic play.
He comes off. I'll be ready.
Crowd on their feet here at the United Center.
It'll be a scoop if anybody but Michael Jordan takes a shot.
It is Michael Jordan time. Scottie Pippen looking for Michael Jordan.
Michael, 6 seconds, five. Michael in traffic to Kerr, 15-footer.
Buried the jumper. Second, remaining in the fourth quarter.
Russell to inbound. Looking. Skipped across, Pippen the steal. Scottie saves it to Tony. He runs the second unit. The Bulls win.
The Bulls have won their fifth championship in the last 7 years.
They do it, the drive for five.
Tonight, Steve Kerr earned his wings, you know, from my perspective, you know, because I had faith in him and he believed in himself and I passed him the ball and he knocked the shot down.
An extraordinary effort. Congratulations, Chicago. Congratulations, Chicago Bulls. Congratulations, these spectacular players.
One of the hardest things in sports to try to do is defend a championship that you have. The Bulls have been able to do it. Repeat.
Wow, five times in 7 years, they are the best in the world.
I want to take my hat off to the two leaders on this team, Scottie and Michael.
Congratulations, Michael Jordan, 1997 Finals MVP.
It's hard to take this MVP by myself. He's got to take half of it. I take the trophy, he may get the car.
It looks like they're celebrating New Year's Eve here in the United Center.
There we go, now we're filming you, filming me, filming us at our annual year-end party.
Okay, let's go ahead. I really appreciate it.
Just telling my guys, good job.
Thank you.
You're going to stay competitive all the way.
And tell Chelsea congratulations, and I hope she enjoys college.
You know, last year, I wanted to kiss my wife, and I actually accidentally reached for Lindsey Bushler. So this year, I guess I should actually reach my own.
Yeah.
This is my fifth time. I do it anytime. I do it 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I will do it again.
A lot of people have been asking me about the shot the other night.
and there have been some misconceptions about what actually happened. I wanted to clear it up. When we called timeout with 25 seconds to go, we went into the huddle. Phil told Michael, he said, Michael, I want you to take the last shot. And Michael said, you know, Phil, I don't feel real comfortable in these situations. So maybe we ought to go in another direction. And Scotty came in and said, you know, Phil, Michael said in his commercial that, you know, he's been asked to do this 26 times and he's failed. So why don't we go to Steve? So I thought to myself, well, I guess I got to bail Michael out again.
Oh, beautiful.
But I've been carrying him all year, so, you know, what's one more time? Anyway, the shot went in, and that's my story, and I'm sticking to it.
Great story. That is a great story.
Some people could say MVP once, or twice, or three times.
Hopefully, come 1998, you guys can go out and celebrate and go back to every city and say we won number six. Hopefully, number seven, number eight, number nine, number 10.
Crawford will throw the ball up, and the finals are underway.
ready to go.
We're on the shot clock now. Keeps it on the dribble. Russell's there. Here he is. Pull up 18-footer. Yes! And the buzzer! Right baseline. Come to the glass. Now for the layup. Left.
Oh, that's a beauty!